Good morning, chaps. I trust you are tickety-boo. You may have noticed I have been missing for a few days. But fear not, I've been working hard on coding my soon-to-be-released storyboard management software, which I will be using today in order to show you how to use VACE 2.2 in a WAM dual model workflow to restyle a video. If, like me, you're in this game to make movies rather than just TikTok dances, then you will likely have already discovered that organization of your media files is essential. So what you are looking at here, I will go into in more detail in another video, explaining the storyboard management software that I hope to make available soon. Link in the text if you want to know more about that. But here you can see I have my messenger on a horse shot that is part of my Highwayman film project, and all the necessary video clips for this shot I have organized here. It's not the best of clips. The color and look is wrong, and it ended it not sitting well with the other shots, which I will quickly show you so you see what I mean. And what I am going to show you today is going from this original video clip style to this style, and I will show you how to do that. You can of course see mixed styles in this set of clips because I have already done it. And if you look at this one, it is the end result where I have swapped the character back in, which I detail in other videos. So to be clear, today is about restyling a general video and not replacing characters. So I don't really care what the character looks like. It is about the environmental look. That is what I'm planning to change. And since that makes this a video to video process, it means we need to turn the original video into a control net that we can then use to drive VACE. And here is the kind of thing I currently make to do that.
I will use this video with VACE to make the new restyled version.
So let's turn our attention now to that workflow. And if you have followed any of my other videos, you will probably recognize this workflow. It is indeed the VACE 2.2 dual model WAM 2.2 workflow. And for the benefit of newcomers, we have here the high noise model first, and you can see the VACE module FP8ED5M2 going into a WAN 2.2 FP8ED5M2 model. Now yes, this is at 19 gigabytes of file sizes, but I am running it on a 3060 12 gigabyte VRAM GPU. Not magic, just dispelling the myth that file size matters. This is the Kijai wrapper workflow. And those models work well with my card. You can, of course, use any model mix you like, but you will need VACE, and you will need WAM. And here is the low noise model, where you can also see the block swapping and torch compile nodes that help me make this workflow run at all. I have installed Sage version 1 and PyTorch 2.7, along with CUDA 12.8. At this point, I haven't felt the need to upgrade further, and I believe there are some issues with PyTorch 2.8. You can see here again matching model types for VACE FP8 ED5M2 module with WAN 2.2 FP8 ED5M2 model. The tiny VAE model you see there is for previewing the result of the high noise model. Let's look next at the sampler section. And this is of course a dual model workflow, so we need to use two samplers. Some people even like to use three samplers, but I am not one of those crazy cats. This section has stirred a number of questions of late, and I will be honest, I'm not an expert on how it all works. This section was inherited from a dual model workflow, and I haven't touched it since I got it. I can tell you that the reason for using CFG2 in the first step and CFG1 for the rest is to help drive the motion for the first step, especially important for the high noise model. Why? Because the high noise model deals with the structure of the result, and the low noise model deals more with details. Another thing people like to fiddle around with is the shift, which you can see there is currently set to 5. If you set that to 2, it would spend more time in the low noise model, and setting it to 12 would be more on the high noise. The details of why I will leave for now. Suffice to say that because we are working with image to video, or video to video with a reference image, it is unlikely to be much value for us. If it was a text-to-video workflow, that might all be more relevant. So to the control net section, and I have this section bypassed most of the time. I only use it when I want to make a control net video. I also have workflows specifically for creating control nets from videos, but keep it in this VACE workflow for convenience. Talking you through it, we begin with loading my original video that I plan to restyle. We then make a depth map of the entire video, but also use DW pose to capture the body and face of the horse rider. We then blend those two control nets together in a ratio of 0.25 using screen method. And the result is, as you have seen already, a colored horse rider and some pine trees as depth map. And this will be used by VACE to maintain the structure of the original video while allowing us to provide a new look for it. And that new look comes from a previously edited first frame that we input as a reference start frame to the workflow. I have used Nano Banana to take a first frame screenshot from the original video and then mucked about with it until I felt it looked right. This will be used as a reference for the restyling by the VACE nodes that we will look at shortly. You can see I'm using 40 AP as a size, and that is only because I wanted to do a quick run for this example. I would of course do higher, and if I could not achieve 720p with this video workflow, I would get as close as possible, then use A-scaler workflows, which I've also done videos on, so check those out. A new and worthwhile model to look at is Flash VSR, and I will be doing a video on it in the future when I get time. We set 81 frames here because it is standard for WAN models, as well as the length at 16 frames per second for our controlnet video, so everything keeps to a standard. If I wanted to get it to 25 frames per second, which I will eventually, then I do that later using interpolation methods. I don't do that here. Next we come to the VACE nodes themselves, and there are two in this workflow. The first VACE node takes the start frame, which is our reference image that I just showed you. I leave the end frame empty on this occasion. But it's the same workflow I use for the FFLF first frame, last frame, and if I was using it for that purpose, I would provide an end frame. It works fine without. We have also got the ControlNet video plugged into that VACE node via the Control Images slot. That is the depth map and pose blended video I showed you just now. This all goes into the VACE encode node as image and as mask. The connectors you see that go off the bottom of the screen are just going to preview so I can see what the VACE node is seeing. And zooming out a bit from that section, you can see I have now bypass the control net creating section in the bottom and loaded up the blended depth map and pose video in the bottom right. The other thing to mention is the prompt and text encode. I now use the T5 cached text encoder as it works best for me in the wrapper workflows. If I wasn't using this, I would use a GGUF version, and you might find that in older versions of this workflow. The advantage of this one is it caches the prompt, so it's quicker if you do more runs before changing it. It also offloads itself from memory. Yeah, whether that is better than any other text encoder approach, I couldn't tell you for sure. And the prompt itself is just a basic one to inform the model of what it is supposed to be doing. You could probably get away with leaving it empty, since you are providing a control net for structure and an image for style. But it's likely best to add something here just to keep it on track. And lastly, we come to the output results. In the top left is the high noise model preview. In the bottom left is the final result of high noise after it has passed through low noise model. In the top right, or playing for some reason, is the original video. And in the bottom right is the control net that we took from that original video. And that brings us to the end of this VACE workflow for restyling. It's actually pretty straightforward. And for those of you interested in this storyboard management software that you can see on the screen at the moment, I will be working on that for the foreseeable future until I am able to release version 1. More details on that can be found on the website, and of course, workflows and so on for the VACE restyling are available there too via the link in the text of this video. Next video will either be an advanced method of using 3D modeling to get new camera angles, or I might do one on storyboard management and discuss why it is so important as we become able to make longer videos that are more involved and actually have story and not just TikTok dances. Till next time then, ciao for now, bambinos.